Hello, I'm Bill Hack, the fire chief for the city of Rockland. During disasters, the most important job we have in emergency management is to get our residents out of harm's way. We respond to both incidents in the city and provide mutual aid to other cities and unincorporated areas that all lead to one major interchange, the Interstate 80 Highway 65 interchange. With our county growing in population and more businesses relocating to Placer County, the heavily traveled 80-65 interchange can become congested and backed up during a disaster. This makes it nearly impossible for our teams to get in to help residents and for residents to get out of the area safely. Future interchange improvements can help foster the growth of our county and create a better quality of life, but make it safer passage for our residents.
Hello, I'm Chief Lee of the Lincoln Fire and Police Departments. With congestion on our freeways, our first responders have to take alternate routes, including taking side streets through Lincoln and the county. This adds significant minutes to our response time, which can be catastrophic when sometimes just minutes are the difference between saving a life and tragedy. Securing funds and completing phase two of the Interstate 80 Highway 65 Interchange Improvement Project can help give those minutes back to our firefighters on their emergency calls. Adding additional lanes to each of the four connectors in the interchange will not only help relieve congestion, but will also encourage more drivers to take the freeway rather than cutting through traffic by using side and local roads. When our first responders have to worry about sitting in backed up traffic, they can't focus on the job at hand to save lives of our residents and to maintain a safe Placer County.
Hi, my name is Dr. Joseph Morris. I am the chief of the Kaiser Permanente Roseville Medical Center Emergency Department. You may have heard the term time loss is brain loss, but that actually applies to a lot of medical problems, such as sepsis and heart attacks. To treat my patients, I need them here as quick as possible. If our first responders can get our patients to us as quickly as possible, the patient benefits and the community benefits.
Hello, I'm Dr. Peter Hall. I'm the Chief Medical Executive at Sutter Roseville Medical Center, and I'm an emergency room physician and have lived in this community for 24 years. Sutter Roseville Medical Center is the only trauma center in Placer County. We act as the regional hub, receiving the largest number of EMS patients 24 hours a day, every day. Our team of trauma surgeons, anesthesiologists, emergency room physicians and specialists, as well as nurses, receive critical patients from a growing 10-county region. Many of our medical procedures rely on quick implementation to save lives and reduce recovery time. That is why improving emergency response times is so important to us as caregivers and to our patients and their families.
Hello, I am Chief Barti of the Roseville Fire Department. I joined the Roseville community as a fire chief about 5 years ago. I'm excited to work for a city that makes safety a priority and forward-thinking community that comes to transportation improvements. Our department's mission is to protect and enhance the safety and well-being of the residents, businesses, and visitors throughout the Roseville community. Our department includes 119 men and women, of which 107 are paramedic or emergency medical technician certified. These men and women respond to emergency situations with confidence that their skills will help save a life. In order to do that, they need efficient and safe access throughout the city. Roseville is located at the base of 80-65 interchange. That means our firefighters often travel down I-80 or across Highway 65 to respond to emergencies, both of which are getting more congested. Because of funding for transportation has changed at the state and federal levels in the past 5 years, it has set our region back. Unless we can meet the new funding requirements, we'll continue to see more congestion. Though these improvements are costly, our city leaders are working hard with regional leaders to create a safer route for our firefighters to accomplish our mission.